This conference will now be recorded.
Just give me a minute, I am sharing my screen. Okay, just confirm me once you are able to see my screen.
Yes, we were able to.
Okay, great, great. So, first of all, welcome to this SAP S/4HANA Finance demo session. Okay. Let me take you through the agenda for this demo. So, we'll start this demo with the introduction. Okay, then I will give you the introduction about the demo topics, then PowerPoint presentation, and then course of introduction, and then questions related to the course contents. You can ask me if you are having any other questions related to the administration part. You can ask the coordinator Harsha or Nikita. Okay, so let's start with the introduction. Let me introduce myself. My name is Gaurav Kumar. I am having total 16 years of experience, and in this 16 years, first 6 years I was working in finance domain, and after that I entered into SAP environment, and from last 10 years I am working in SAP, and in this 10 years, from last 3.5 years I am working in HANA environment, S/4HANA Finance. Okay, I completed one S/4HANA Finance greenfield implementation. Right now I am working on one S/4HANA Finance migration project. Okay, so that was my short introduction. It will be good if you introduce yourself one by one. Let's start with Nagesh.
Okay, myself Nagendra, I'm from Bangalore. Mm-hmm. I have like 8 years experience in healthcare industry, not in completely in SAP.
Mm-hmm.
And last year I have completed SAP FICO training. So I want to get into S/4HANA. So I joined this demo session. Thank you.
Okay, okay, great, great. Yes. Yeah. Okay, next one, I think Sumit.
Okay, so my name is Sumit Gupta. I'm actually originally from Mumbai, but right now I'm in US. I have a few years of SAP experience, but on R3 and ECC. So trying to get some understanding on how S/4HANA works, so that I can get into new projects with S/4HANA.
Okay. Okay. Great. Yes. Okay, I think the third candidate is Rajesh.
One more is Rubin.
Rubin, yeah. Sorry. So Rubin, are you there?
One more is also join, Soumendra. Indra, Jubin, and Rajesh.
Mm-hmm. Okay, Soumendra, can you introduce yourself?
Yeah, Soumendra here. I'm working in a company around 12 years of experience in SAP FICO. Mm-hmm. So, interested for this session. So, for that, I joined.
Okay, great. Yes. Okay, thank you all of you for your introduction. Okay, let me take you to the demo topics. Okay, so in today's demo, we are going to see what are the common problems faced by the finance teams all over the world. Okay, and then overview of functionalities and benefits provided by SAP S/4HANA Finance, and then universal journal entry solution, which is introduced newly in S/4HANA Finance, and then available deployment option, and then we will have a glimpse about the adoption options for existing customers and central finance solution. Okay, so before starting with these demo topics, I would like to understand, obviously, when if you decided to go with the S/4HANA Finance Learning, so you are attending this demo session, so obviously before coming to this demo session, you have gone through some articles, you read some books, or you search this on Google. So what is your understanding about S/4HANA Finance? So I would like to understand your views. Yes, Nagendra.
Got much about, I don't know this thing, but it's like instead of rows in S/4HANA, it will be like columns. I just read somewhere. Okay, that's it. I don't know much about this thing.
Okay, okay. So, Mendra, what do you know about S/4HANA Finance?
Actually, as per me, actually presently also I am working in S/4HANA, the Pico module. Okay, so regarding that, there is some, actually I know the functionality, what are, means I Pico level only I can say that, means what are the new changes are going on and what is that. So, but I know that this is faster than compared to ECC, that's it only.
Okay, okay, good. Sumit?
Yeah, so I was reading couple of articles. So one, it is based on in memory. It is column based. Indexation. So like in earlier database for one entry, whenever there was a change, SAP used to rewrite that all the row. So for one say like sales document, we would have eventually end up 30-35 line items with different changes. But now you can specifically change one column, so you don't add up all those line items in the database and then less indexing and all that stuff. So it is much more faster. It gives you much more prompt result. You can do a lot of analysis. So you can do FICO reconciliation real time because it is in memory and it is all. And in Universal Journal, you have the entire CO and FI together. So there is nothing left for reconciliation. So there's a lot of benefits.
Yes, very, very much correct. In short, now SAP is using row and columnar based database. Okay. Right. And they are trying to integrate each and every area at the one platform. That's why they introduced this Universal Journal Entry solution. Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay, great. Yeah. So let's start with these demo topics. Okay, some common challenges and solutions. Okay, so the first challenge here is the slower reporting and closing due to complex data model. Okay, so as all we know that we can go to client, we can make the implementation. Once implementation is completed, client will be happy with all the functionalities provided by SAP ECC, but they will not happy with the issues like slower reporting and the time it was taking for the closing. Okay, because there is a reason for these issues. Like if you are not using HANA database, okay, to run your SAP platform, probably you are using SQL or Oracle database or any other third party database. Okay, and these databases, SQL, Oracle or any other third party database, they were developed near about 35-40 years back. Okay, and when they were developed, there was very limited availability of RAM, so they developed in a way so where data will be get stored on hard disk, that is your ROM, and when we try to fetch the data for the reporting purpose, it will take time when the data was getting fetched from the hard disk and then the RAM. Okay, so that's why SAP come up with the SAP HANA database, okay, which is called as the in-memory technology. Okay, it is having in-memory capability for providing columnar database and for simplified data model, which helps in insight instant insight. Okay, so let me give you an example of what happens in ECC when you post any accounting entry. Let it be any accounting entry, simple debit and credit accounting entry. There will be several tables which are going to be posted. Okay, so basic table will be get posted. Okay, for line items, BKPF table will get posted for master data, header data. And then BSEC table is going to be posted. Then there are other tables like BSIS, BSID, BSIC. Okay, if you are using new GL accounting, then again FAGL Flex A, FAGL Flex T, these tables are going to be posted. And if you check all these tables, you will understand that the same data is going to be posted in different tables. Okay, so why? What is the reason the same data is going to be posted in different tables? Okay, the reason behind that is the database or data model, which is designed in such a way that data will be stored in hard disk in different components. Okay, so because of that, data is stored in a different places. When we try to fetch that data in a one single screen, it will take some time. Okay, if you are running some balance sheets or big reports for long duration, like 6 months or a year, sometime it happens the system give us the runtime error, the timeout error, because system will not able to run this report to fetch the data for more than 15-20 minutes. Okay, so to cater all the these issues about the slow reporting and closing, okay, SAP come up with the new changes in the data model. Okay, and SAP come up with the in-memory technology based HANA database. Okay, where it is going to save the data in columnar database, and then again SAP start introducing the data model changes, because SAP HANA was introduced in way back in 2011. Okay, it is introduced as a HANA database only. In 2013, they introduced the first area which is embedded with S4HANA, that is BW. Right now also, if you go for the SAP HANA, you will get the SAP HANA BW embedded with SAP HANA. Okay, and in 2015 they actually start changing the data model. Okay, by introducing S4HANA Finance. That time it was called as a simple finance. So what was this data models? So data model, like in 2011 they introduced this SAP HANA, but still ECC platform was running on the same data model, means data was going to be stored in a different places and in a different tables. Okay, so SAP started those data model changes from 2015, where they introduced simple finance. Okay, and till now in 2019 also they introducing the new changes by every quarter or by every year. Okay, but most of the finance related changes were introduced in 2015 only. Okay, so that was the first point, slower reporting and closing. The second point is time consuming reconciliation. Okay, so as we are talking about the data model changes, and as Soumendra Sumit I think told us that now there is no need of reconciliation between finance and controlling. Okay, so that is very much true. So there is no need of reconcile the totals and the controlling or material ledger or COPA tables. Okay, because all these tables will be updated in the single line item table, which is called as a universal journal. Okay, and SAP is calling this or marketing this universal journal solution as a single source of truth. Why? Because now SAP has introduced a new table, that technical name of that table is ACDOCA. Some people called it as ACDOCA, some people called it as ACDOCA. Okay, so this new table was introduced where all the details will be get saved, okay, in one place and in one table. So it would not be difficult to fetch that data. Okay, so now there is no need of reconciliation. Previously it was needed because data was getting saved in different places and in a different tables, but now it is going to save in a single table, so there is no need of reconciliation anymore. So we can save that time. The third challenge here is high cost of operation. Okay, so if you know that in till the time of introducing the cloud solution of SAP, whatever servers you are having or whatever landscapes you are having with your client, those are on-premise landscapes. Okay, so what happens in on-premise, you need to your client need to spend much money on operations. Okay, so to reduce this cost of operation, okay, SAP introduced the new module called Fury. SAP called this as a beautiful user experience also. Okay, and this Fury module can work on any device, whether it will be your tablet, laptop, desktop or mobile phones. Okay, so it can work on any device. Okay, and it means that you can give faster approval or you can complete your activities at a very fast space, and again you can train your users very well. So by using this Fury module, we can reduce the cost of operations. Okay, the fourth point here is high cost of infrastructure. So if you are into on-premise landscape, okay, so your client need to take care of that server, your client need to make sure that that server should be up and running, they need to take care of software as well as hardware. Okay, so they need to spend their money on hardware also, and again they need to have resource to manage that network and hardware. Okay, so they need to spend their money on resources also and on their trainings also. Okay, so for this issue, SAP come up with the solution to lower the cost of hardware and software licenses, like cloud services and leasing the applications. So SAP can go with, any client can go with the cloud services, and they can lease the application whatever they need, and then they can save their cost on infrastructure also. Okay, so these there are so many challenges depend upon the area of working or business area or geographical area. Okay, but these are the some of the common ones and the solutions which are provided by SAP for these challenges. So any question here?
No, we are good.
Okay, great. Okay, so let's understand current architecture of ECC before going to see what is the new thing. Okay, so if you see this picture, center of this picture there is a yellow box which is representing GL accounting. On the left hand side there are two yellow boxes which representing material ledger and asset accounting, and on right hand side there are two yellow boxes which representing the controlling area areas of working. Okay, so whenever we do the accounting, okay, anyways it is going to be post to the GL accounts. Okay, but at the end of the month or at the end of the year, we need to do the reconcile, because data is stored at the different places. So we need to make sure that all the submodules will reconcile with the GL accounting. Okay, so there are different submodules like material ledger, asset accounting, and controlling, account receivable, account payable. Okay, so all these submodules needs to be reconciled with GL accounting to make sure that our balance sheet and profit and loss account would be get tallied. Okay, so again for that we need to spend a lot of time to reconcile this thing and finalize our balance sheet and profit and loss account, and we need to spend a lot of money also on that. So that's why we are not able to close our month end or year end in a time or not below than 5 days. Okay, so why this was happening, because of the architecture, because the data in ECC data will be stored in multiple components and multiple tables are updated for a single transaction to update these components, and there is a huge efforts required for reconciliation. Okay, so that was the current scenario, the current architecture. Okay, let's understand the new architecture, that is universal journal entry solution. Okay, so in this picture, if you see in the middle, there is a universal journal box. Okay, which represents the new table ACDOC A or ACDOCA. Okay, So in this is the new table which is introduced for universal journal entry solution. If you remember, when SAP introduced the new GL accounting, SAP that time also SAP introduced the new table that is called FHL FlexA. So now they introduce again the new table that is SC DOCA. Okay, so what this universal journal solution will do, it will going to store the data, okay, in a single table, in a single place, that is SC DOCA, and it is going to receive the details or values from GL accounting, controlling, asset accounting, material ledger, all the areas. So this universal journal entry solution, it takes the values from all the areas, and there will be only one line item with all the details of all the components, and because of this functionality, there is no need of reconciliation. So if you remember, in asset accounting also, in ECG, if you check, when you post any asset accounting related transaction, there are only few details which you can find in finance side. Okay, if you need some details regarding the assets, you need to refer to asset accounting tables. Okay, but here that is not the case in universal journal entry table SC DOCA. So here you will find all the details in a single line item. Okay, I am following this table from 2015. Okay, initially there was 250 fields, and right now there is more than 375 fields. Okay, so SAP is improving this table day by day, and they are trying to accommodate details from all the areas. So in SAP, whenever any financial transaction take place in any module, whether it will be finance, CO or PP, MM, HD, wherever any finance object comes into the picture, then definitely this table is going to capture that data. Okay, so that is the new architecture for universal journal entry solution. So any question here? Okay, I hope everything is good. Let's go ahead. Let's talk about the deployment options. So for S/4HANA Finance, there are three deployment options. One is on-premise, second one is on-cloud, and the third one is hybrid deployment option. Okay, so let's have a look what are these deployment options. Okay, on-premise has a deployment option. The advantage of this on-premise deployment option is like your client will have full control over the system and the implementation, and even they can control the functional configuration and the modification also. So right now, whoever the client who are using SAP ECC, they are using on-premise deployment option, okay, where they can decide which patch they need to update in the server, which upgradation, whether it will be software or hardware, which needs to be done there. Everything will be decided by client. Okay, so the hold they will hold the server in their hand. Okay, they will have full control over the server. Okay, but again, on another hand, there is a disadvantage of this on-premise deployment option or on-premise server. Like on-premise deployment requires ongoing investment to manage and purchase all the software as well as this hardware. Okay, because it is managed by the client, they need to take care of the server, and they need to make sure that it should be up and running. Okay, and then again, client need to invest time and money on the employees also. Okay, because if they want to make sure that this server should be up and running, then their resources should be capable enough. Okay, so client need to spend money and time on their trainings also. Okay, so that is on-premise deployment option which is available. The next deployment option available is a cloud deployment option. So advantage of the cloud deployment option is like there is a low infrastructure cost, because this cloud infrastructure and the applications which client is going to use, those are managed on the subscription basis, okay, by SAP. Okay, and this cloud environment will be continuously upgraded by SAP. So client will get the latest and the most advanced version of the environment. Okay, So whatever new things SAP is introducing, SAP will apply on the cloud and client can enjoy those new changes. Okay, but again, there is a disadvantage for the same thing that client will not have any kind of control on any kind of modification. If client is happy with the current scenario and if SAP is coming with the new changes, client can't say no. Client can't say that, okay, I don't want this change because I am happy with the current functionality. Because the cloud platform which is used by that client, that could be used by other 100 clients also. Okay, so client don't have any option to deny the changes done by SAP. Okay, that would be the disadvantage for cloud. But again, on the cloud, there are different services like private cloud or cloud as a service. Okay, so if your client is having private cloud, then client will have control on the private cloud. If client is going with the public cloud, then SAP will have full control over the cloud. Okay, but there is another third option, deployment option, and that is a hybrid as a deployment option. So hybrid is the combination of on-premise deployment option and cloud deployment option. Okay, and it can be used in such a process where they don't need to integrate with the SAP business suite and can be easily taken away from the SAP. Okay, so for example, large companies which are using on-premise implementation can go for the run specific functions of organizations such as remote sales office or subsidiaries or recent mergers and acquisitions on cloud. Okay, and organization can use the cloud with an integration with their on-premise systems for consolidated reporting and disclosures. And there are no advantages or disadvantages for this hybrid deployment option, because hybrid deployment option is a mix of on-premise and cloud. Okay, so client can decide which processes or which data they want to keep on-premise and which data and processes they want to keep on cloud. So it's up to client how they can utilize this hybrid deployment option. Okay, so these are the three deployment options. So any question here?
No, we are good. I'm good.
Okay, great. That's good. Yeah. Okay, let's go ahead. Okay, so let's talk about the adoption scenarios for existing customers. So if you see this picture, okay, there are three adoption options. Okay, on the left hand side upper corner, there is a first option, that is upgrade and migrate. Okay, so I will take an example that on the left hand side of this option, there are three gray boxes which represents SAP ERP or SAP R3. Okay, and here we need to migrate it to, and they want to go with the S/4HANA Finance. Okay, so what we need to do here, we need to upgrade the database and then migrate the transaction values to S/4HANA Finance environment. Okay, so this is the first option, that is upgrade and migrate, but the landscape will be the same. Three environments will be created with the new system, new changes. Okay, that is upgrade and migrate. The second option here is upgrade, migrate and consolidate. Okay, so here again I will take an example of the landscape where three environments are available for SAP ERP or SAP R3. So here what we are going to do, we are going to upgrade the database to SAP HANA, and then we are going to migrate the transactional values to S/4HANA Finance, and then at the same time we are going to consolidate that data in a single environment. Okay, so previously there were three environments, but now in the new landscape there will be only one environment. So that is the second option, the upgrade, migrate and consolidate. Okay, it will reduce the number of instances. Okay, and there is a third option available, that is the replicate into central finance system. Okay, so here also I will take in the example of three different environments in one single landscape which can represent the SAP ERP, SAP R3 or any other third party accounting tool or ERP. Okay, so here what happens, we are not going to do any upgrade or any migrate. Okay, but we are going to replicate the data in S/4HANA Finance system with the help of central finance system. Okay, So Central Finance is the another solution which is introduced by SAP with this S/4HANA Finance changes. Okay, so let me take you to next slide where I can explain you the Central Finance solution. Okay, so here on this picture you can see on the left hand side there are two gray boxes. One is representing SAP R3 and the next one is representing the non-SAP ERP box. Okay, and both these landscapes will can create the financial accounting documents. Okay, so whenever any financial accounting document create in these both these landscape, the database will be get triggered to SAP landscape transformation replication server. In SAP world we called it as a SLTR server. Okay, and with the SLTR server, that data is going to be reflected into S/4HANA Finance system. Okay, where we are going to do the business mapping and error correction, and then it will went to actual SAP HANA tables. Okay, universal journal entry, and there you can process that data further, or you can prepare report for that. Okay, so Central Finance solution is the different from S/4HANA Finance. Okay, this is the separate solution provided by SAP for those clients who don't want to change their landscape as like the first option and the second option, because they are happy with the current landscape, but at the same time they want to get the benefit of the new changes. Okay, so the old landscape will be remain as it is, and the only data will be replicated into the S/4HANA Finance landscape where we can process it further. Okay, so there Central Finance solution will work. So any questions here?
Hi Gaurav.
Yes.
I wanted to ask one question. If a client is using Central Finance, so does it mean that they will not go to completely on HANA in the hands-on transactions?
No, they can use hands-on transaction because there is a separate box created for S/4HANA Finance. Okay, only the thing is data will be replicated from the old system to S/4HANA Finance, and further their client can analysis for that data, or they can do further transactions. They can use different transactions over there for that data.
So basically, if they implement Central Finance successfully, then will they be using the old ECC transactions, or else they will be migrated to the new transactions which are there, and they will be using those AC DOCA tables and all those things?
Yeah, they will use AC DOCA table also, but at the same time they can use the old transaction also, because both the landscapes are there, and Central Finance is the solution which connects the old landscape and new landscape. Okay, so that is the reason why Central Finance was introduced, because there are clients who don't want to change their old landscape, but still they want to get benefit of this S/4HANA Finance changes.
So probably they are just using the reporting benefit of that, of HANA,
the
right?
Reporting benefit, or if once the accounting entries come into the S/4HANA Finance landscape, they can do further transactions in S/4HANA Finance, or just reporting, as you said.
Mm-hmm. Okay, because many of the people are having one doubt that Central Finance is something kind of a mid place between ECC and HANA. So some can go to Central Finance, meanwhile they are using HANA reports, and then later on they will move to HANA. So that is one of the major confusions many people which are having.
It's not like that. Central Finance is a mediator which can connect to your old landscape to the S/4HANA Finance landscape. Okay, and it's not needed that the old landscape should be from SAP. It could be non-SAP ERP also. It could be Microsoft Dynamics or Oracle or any other local ERP or Tally. So it can also connect to Central Finance to S/4HANA Finance landscape.
Okay, thanks Gaurav.
Yeah.
So one question. So if you said that people can also do some post processing in the SAP HANA once the entries are replicated in the Central Finance, right? So mm-hmm. if somebody is doing some transactions in the HANA database, does it back replicate also to the existing ERP, or how does that work then?
No, if it is required, that kind of setting can be done. That kind of configuration can be done if it is required. Okay. That is also possible.
So you can so basically you post something in your local ERP, then central finance solution transfers it to the HANA database. You make some entries in the HANA database. Does it get back posted?
Yeah, it is possible, but okay. it needed a separate configuration and settings.
Okay. Okay. So, but in your experience, what have you seen? What are people using central finance for? Is it majorly reporting?
Normally people use central finance to get the data in SAP S/4HANA finance landscape, but they don't post it back to local ERP, because they are taking central finance or S/4HANA finance landscape because there are some limitations working with local ERP or any other ERP.
No, agree. So I'm just asking, so in your experience, what is the majority of people using central finance for? Is it majorly for reporting, faster reporting?
Yeah, majorly for faster reporting and majorly for consolidation of the database from different locations or different ERPs.
Okay. Thank you.
Yes. Okay. So let me give you the course introduction. Okay, this is the short course introduction. So in this course, we will have an overview of SAP HANA, overview of S/4HANA. Then we'll go through what are the scope and impact of S/4HANA finance. Okay, then we are going to start the configuration. Okay, and in configuration, we are going to configure the new functionalities which are available in S/4HANA finance, which include GL accounting area, asset accounting and management accounting, okay, and few other areas which are changed. Okay, and once we completed this configuration, then we'll go for the migration. Okay, and in the migration, we'll understand the prerequisite of migration for S/4HANA finance, then the configuration needed with the system for the preparation of migration, and what are the migration steps from classic to new GL accounting, and the standard migration tool provided by SAP. We're going to see that. So this course can be divided into three parts. The first part is overview, which is most of the theory part, overview of SAP HANA, overview of S/4HANA, and the scope and impact of S/4HANA finance. Then second part is like a greenfield implementation, where we are going to do the configuration from scratch. We are going to configuration with the company and company code, and going ahead, we'll see what are the changes in terms of configuration, okay, in all the areas in finance. And once configuration is finished, we are going to post some transactions, and we are going to see how the transactions got posted into the new data model, okay, and what are the changes in terms of transactions and in terms of the screens, okay. And once this activity is completed, then we are going to look into the migration project. Okay, what are the prerequisites for the migration? What are the preparations? What are the configurations required before starting the migration? And how we can do the migration by using the standard tool, that is the SAP Migration Cockpit. Okay, so these are the part we are going to cover in this course. So any question regarding this course content?
You are going to cover that asset accounting as well as management part, means all cost accounting you are going to cover?
Yeah, management accounting we are going to see what are the changes in controlling side in regards to finance. Okay, when we are normally set up any company code, what are all the changes happened from the management accounting side? Those we are going to see over there.
Okay.
Yeah. Sumit, you are asking something?
Yeah, so is this going to include central finance also? Are you going to touch on central finance or no?
No, actually central finance is a separate solution. okay, from S4HANA Finance. So there is a separate altogether course for that.
Okay.
I just give you some about the Central Finance, because people normally get confused about the S4HANA Finance and Central Finance.
So basically, in this course, are you going to tell us only the delta, which is from ECC to S4, or we are going to actually go through the entire configuration of all the modules and see one company code in action full?
Only delta.
Only delta.
Yes, obviously. Because look, this is not the new module. Okay, this is the only change which SAP introduced on the SAP Finance module. Okay, so we are going to focus on the delta, because that is more important.
Because there are a lot of changes in asset accounting. The entire asset accounting concept has changed, and the account based COPA is introduced. So those are the two, I think, heavy changes which we should be aware. And also, is there a different course if we have to do the bank side of the things, you know, like the credit and collections and all that in S4? Is that a different course?
Yeah, there's a different course in this part. In general, GL accounting, we are going to cover regarding the bank account creation, which has also got change in S4HANA Finance. We are going to cover that part. But if you are going for the FSCM or treasury module changes, then this is a different thing.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Okay. So if we have to ask about other courses, we need to contact Nikita or Harsha, right?
Yeah, Nikita or Harsha, you can contact them.
Okay, I'll probably speak to them after this class.
Yeah, sure.
So how long is the course, and you know, what are the timings and all that? Are you going to cover coming to that? Or?
Yeah, so course duration is normally 20 to 25 hours. Okay, yes. But once it starts, I don't count on hours, because your understanding is more important than the hours.
Okay.
But normally, averagely, it will take 20 to 25 hours.
And is
and
it
timings? Yeah. Timings will be decided as per my and your availability, because I am also full-time working. Okay, mm-hmm. I am not a freelancer or a full-time trainer. So I am also working. So by the mutual understanding, we will decide the time and start the class.
Okay, and is it everyday class, or weekend also is possible? Like if you want a, you know, 2-hour weekend class, is that also possible?
Yes, that is also possible. If you want weekdays classes, we will have 1-hour class daily. Okay, if you want weekdays weekend classes, then we can have 2 hours on Saturday and 2 hours on Sunday. That is also possible.
Okay,
great. Any other question, guys?
So what about the course fees and all that? Will that be discussed with Nikita?
Yeah, you can discuss with the your coordinator.
Okay.
Yeah. Nagendra, Shiv Kumar, Somendra, any questions?
Gaurav, actually in this course introduction, what are the course details you have provided? In that course only, what are the changes in S4HANA compared to ECC or something? That only you can teach to us, right?
Yes.
Not in details, right?
No, I'm not going to teach you the whole finance module from ECC. We are going to focus on data. Because for teaching SAP finance module, it will take 60 to 90 hours.
So actually, as per my knowledge, CO is very huge in S4HANA. There is a lot of changes in S4HANA. That you are going to tell us only what are the changes are required, right? In that case.
Yeah, we are going
Means
to
like
talk
I am
about
giving an example. Suppose in finance.
Mm-hmm.
No, suppose I am telling you that scenario is suppose business partner is introduced in S4HANA, right?
Yes.
In that
yes,
case, in vendor only that. you are creating. Like that only you have to tell us what are the new functionality. What is introduced in S4HANA, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Like business partner, like Sumit said, there is a much difference in asset accounting. They change the whole asset accounting configuration and processes. We are going to focus on that. We are going to see what is the business partner, why it is required, what is the configuration required for business partner.
Okay. Okay.
Okay, great, great. Okay. Okay, guys. So if you don't have any other question, we'll conclude this session here. Thank you very much for attending this session. And if you are having any other queries further, you can get in touch with your coordinators. Okay. If you want any explanation further, you can ask them to set up a call with me, and I am very happy to talk with you.
Okay.
Okay. Great. Thank you. Thank you, everyone.
Thanks, sir.
Thanks. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Bye-bye.